mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray that he will keep this city and this holy church and every city and country from wrath, famine, pestilence, earthquake, flood, fire, the sword, the invasion of enemies, and from civil war, and from all sudden death, and that our good God, who loves mankind, will be gracious, favorable, and conciliatory, and turn away and dispel all the wrath stirred up against us, and all sickness, and may deliver us from his righteous chastisement, which impendeth against us, and have mercy on us. God, our Savior, the hope of all the ends of the earth, and of those who are far off upon the sea, and show mercy, O Master, upon us sinners, and have mercy on us. For thou art a merciful God, who lovest mankind, and unto thee do we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our sure hope. Glory to thee.
Glory.
grants us eternal life.
Thank you. I
Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend.
At that time, the Sabbath was past. Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices that they might come and anoint him. Very early in the morning on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb when the sun had risen, and they said among themselves, "Who will roll away the stone from the door of the tomb for us?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away, for it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who is crucified. He is risen, he is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him as he said to you." So they went out quickly and fled from the tomb, for they trembled and were amazed. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to
thee. Glory to the holy, consubstantial, life creating and undivided Trinity, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
Let God
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs.
Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee from before his face.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
As smoke vanishes, so let them vanish. As wax melts before the fire.
His was fresh and he spread peace. Death is dead for proud. His lordship for a bishop of the above.
So the sinners will perish before the face of God. But let the righteous be glad.
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
His cross was stressed and he spent it. Thank you, stand for proud. His lordship for the beauty for the above.
To the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
His gospel scarce any sent me, then feels death of doubt. In soon she bore a vision on her mouth.
Christ is risen from the dead.
Oh,
and
mercy
for the present and the Christ is risen.
If any man be a wise servant, let him rejoicing enter into the joy of his Lord. If any have labored long in fasting, let him now receive his recompense. If any have wrought from the first hour, let him today receive his just reward. If any have come at the third hour, let him with thankfulness keep the feast. If any have arrived at the sixth hour, let him have no misgivings, because he shall in no wise be deprived therefore. If any have delayed until the ninth hour, let him draw near, fearing nothing. If any have tarried even until the 11th hour, let him also be not alarmed at his tardiness. For the Lord, who is jealous of his honor, will accept the last even as the first. He gives rest unto him who comes at the 11th hour, even as unto him who has wrought from the first hour. And he shows mercy upon the last and cares for the first. And to the one he gives, and upon the other he bestows gifts. Then he both accepts the deeds and welcomes the intention, and honors the acts and praises the offering. Wherefore, enter all into the joy of your Lord, and receive your reward, both the first and likewise the second. You rich and poor together hold high festival. You sober and you heedless honor the day. Rejoice today, both you who have fasted and you who have disregarded the fast. The table is full laden, feast sumptuously. The calf is fatted, let no one go away hungry. Enjoy all the feast of faith. Receive all the riches of loving kindness. Let no one bewail his poverty, for the universal kingdom has been revealed. Let no one weep for his iniquities, for pardon has shone forth from the grave. Let no one fear death, for the Savior's death has set us free. He that was held prisoner of it has annihilated it. By descending into hell, he made hell captive. He embittered it when it tasted of his flesh. And Isaiah, foretelling this, did cry, "Hell," said he, "was embittered when it encountered thee in the lower regions. It was embittered, for it was abolished. It was embittered, for it was mocked. It was embittered, for it was slain. It was embittered, for it was overthrown. It was embittered, for it was fettered in chains. It took a body and met God face to face. It took earth and encountered heaven. And it took that which was seen and fell upon the unseen. O death, where is thy sting? O hell, where is thy victory? Christ is risen, and you are overthrown. Christ is risen, and the demons are fallen. Christ is risen, and the angels rejoice. Christ is risen, and life reigns. Christ is risen, and not one dead remains in the grave. For Christ, being risen from the dead, has become the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. To him be glory and dominion unto ages of ages. Amen.
Ray shining forth from your lips like a beacon has enlightened thy universe. It has shown to the world the riches of poverty. It has revealed to us the heights of humility. Teaching us by your words of Father John Chrysostom. In their sin before the world Christ are about to say.
Thank you.
his most pure mother, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind.
Amen.
Christ is risen.
Indeed.
Christ is risen.
Indeed, he is risen.
Thank you.
the people. Let us pray to the Lord. Peaceful time.
John bore witness of him and cried out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me is preferred before me, for he was before me.' And of his fullness we have all received, and grace for grace. For the law was given through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ."
Our mind, let us say. Tom, Archbishop of Washington, Metropolitan of all America and Canada, His Eminence Archbishop Paul, Archbishop of Chicago and the Diocese of the Midwest, may the Lord God remember that in His kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
The Holy Priest of the Diocese, may our beloved clergy and people, those who love us and those who hate us, together with those who have no one to pray for them, the sick and the suffering whom we are praying for, those who have fallen asleep in hope of eternal rest, may the Lord God remember them in His kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. The President of this nation and civil authorities, those serving in its armed forces, especially those serving in harm's way, may the Lord God remember them in His kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For you and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember you in His kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
Thank you.
in the fear of God, with faith and love for all dear.
Thank you.
intercessions of the glorious death, O most and ever Virgin Mary, and all thy saints, for thou art our sanctification, and unto thee we ascribe glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Indeed, Jesus.